I worked for my college newspaper at the University of Texas, and then I began to be a rock music critic. I reviewed concerts and albums, and then that was for a publication called the Austin Chronicle, which is the arts and entertainment weekly of Austin, Texas, where I resided. After that, I became a freelance journalist and basically wrote for anybody who would take me. That included some very ignominious publications that are no longer in business, publications that never paid. One thing led to another, and at some point I decided to do a book about the history of Rolling Stone magazine. I convinced Doubleday to publish it. The book critically did very well. It sold fairly well as well, and that, insofar as I was ever put on the map, I guess that put me on the map. That I parlayed into a job with Texas Monthly as a staff writer. I worked there for 6.5 years until GQ magazine hired me away from them in 1997. And that's where I've been ever since. Well, I think proving yourself more than anything else by just doing the work. You know, that people like the president and like most people don't expect access to be handed, to be given on a silver platter. They expect you to earn it. And oftentimes I think young writers make the mistake of thinking, I don't want to take on any of the burdens myself. I want, if you give me all of this stuff, I promise I'll do a good job. But in fact, it really is incumbent upon particularly aspiring journalists to prove that they're the real deal, to prove that they're willing to do the hard work. And I think that good things often come to those who do not look for shortcuts, but actually just kind of plod from one interview to the next, as I did. I'm proud to know Robert Caro, and Bob Caro is a friend of mine, and I think he's a tremendous writer, and he sort of, in a way, reinvented the biographical form. I think he's terrific. I'm a serious reader of fiction and a great lover of Faulkner in particular, and I've written some fiction. I never expect to be in his pantheon or in Bob Caro's pantheon, but I'm admirers of them both. I interviewed Bush when he was governor, and I was a writer for GQ in 98. I was living in Austin. He was at that time considering running for president, and I was sort of did the first definitive profile of him and spent a lot of time with him and his family and his close aides. That was a mutually satisfactory experience. The profile was long and it was fair but revelatory as well. I didn't stay in touch with anybody in Bush world until 2004, when I just decided that for all of the hundreds of books about Bush, there was none that really was a straightforward biography, that he was a consequential president and deserving of serious biographical treatment. So I kind of appointed myself. At the time, I was guaranteed no access really of any kind, but through just sort of plodding along, I managed to get various people in the West Wing to cooperate. One led to another, and then to another, and then finally in August of 2006, the president brought me into the Oval Office for an off-the-record chat in which I sort of sold him on my intent to do a book that wouldn't judge him, that would play it down the middle, and would be a book that would hopefully be of lasting value and not just a book of the moment. And that led ultimately to a series of interviews, 6 of them in all, a total of about 6 hours. The president's actually a pretty complicated guy. He's a guy who can be very dismissive, but he can also be very reflective. He can indeed appear incurious, but at the same time, he's an avid reader, a reader of history, a reader of fiction. He's a good student of people on the one hand, but on the other hand, I think that his need for a comfort zone has caused him to keep people around when they perhaps have burned out and otherwise outlasted their usefulness to the administration. In short, he's a really complicated guy, even though people have tended to view him in very black and white terms, which is, I think, a paradigm he's been satisfied with for the most part, but I think there's much more to him than that.